Julius Caesar noticed that the Celts in Gaul are different from the indigenous people east of the Rhine. His wars in Gaul helped establish the use of the term Germania for the region between Rhine, Danube and Vistula River. In his writings De Bello Gallico, Caesar noted that the Suebians are by far the largest and the most warlike confederation of all Germanic peoples. In 51 BC, he estimated that they had more than 100,000 armed men. In Germania, it is the greatest glory to the several states to have as wide wastelands as possible around them, their frontiers having been laid waste. They consider this the real evidence of their prowess, that their neighbors shall be driven out of their lands and abandon them, and that no one dare settle near them. They esteem it their greatest praise as a nation, that the lands about their territories lie unoccupied to a very great extent, inasmuch as they think that by this circumstance is indicated that a great number of nations cannot withstand their power, and thus, on one side of the Suebians, the lands are said to lie desolate for about 600 miles. In cavalry actions, the Suebians frequently jump from their horses and fight on foot and train their horses to stand still in the very spot on which they leave them, to which they retreat with great activity when there is occasion. The Germans do not pay much attention to agriculture, and a large portion of their food consists in milk, cheese and flesh. Their whole life is occupied in hunting and in the pursuits of the military art. In their forests are animals, which are called Uri. These are a little below the elephant in size and of the appearance, color and shape of a bull. Their strength and speed are extraordinary. They spare neither man nor wild beast, which they have espied. These the Germans take with much pains in pits and kill them. The young men harden themselves with this exercise and practice themselves in this kind of hunting, and those who have slain the greatest number of them, having produced the horns in public to serve as evidence, receive great praise.